So today we're going to be looking at one of the first bass lines I ever learned as a bass player, and it's Jamiroquai's Too Young to Die off the first album. It's a great piece to have in your repertoire, particularly as a practice piece. It's a nice warm-up, great one to play along with the record because it's quite simple to actually learn the notes. There's not too much in it. So as with a lot of bass lines, there's various sort of little variations and bits that on the recording, which you could sort of spend half your life learning each little bit, but I prefer to look at the main riffs, get them down, and then just play along with the record and try and get it in time and sounding good. So the first bit, I'll just move up a little closer here, and the main bit, the first bit we'll learn is this. Okay, so we're just on the first and third frets. We're starting on the A string here, just on the 3rd fret, and the 1st fret, then down to the E string, 1st fret, 3rd fret, and then back up to the A string, 3rd fret. It's just those notes. So. That's it. And then the 2nd bit, in the same area, but we just put this extra note in, so we go 3, 2, 1 on the E string. Okay, and then 3, A string 1, A string 3, and up to the D string, 1st fret. Okay, so it's, and same again. Okay, so that's the first two bits, just play them together. Okay, then on the A string we've got another little 3-2-1. Okay, and then I make a chord shape like this. So I've got my 1-3 there and 4th finger there on the top string, 3rd fret. So we do this little 3-2-1 run down. So you play that chord shape up and then down again. Okay, so it goes. Okay. And again, then an open A string, then that same chord shape again, but up here on the 4th fret, on the strings below, then move it down a fret, okay, so that's, then back to the beginning again. Okay, so let's just look at that, this bit here again, so it's a little bit fiddly. So we do this, 3-2-1 run down, open A string, up to the 4th fret on the strings below, same chord shape. Okay, so that main bit all together. That's it. Fairly straightforward, but for me, I like to put in ghost notes, muted notes within the riff to help drive it along a little bit. So what I literally do, in drumming terms, I get, you call these grace notes, I suppose, is like putting little muted notes. So I'm plucking the string with my fingers there, but not actually fretting a note here, so I'm just muting the string. So what I mean by that is when I play a note, I kind of get this. So I get that muted note in before, and I tend to put them in when it just sort of nothing specific to it, just sort of random places I put them in. It helps keep the groove going. So so I kind of put two in there. I put in one for that F note there. So I go one, two. So I'm putting in just a little muted note before the F there. So then another one just before the second round of that lick. It just keeps it grooving a little better for me. So that's something you might want to try and incorporate in there. Okay, so that's the main section. Then on to the verse. No, the chorus, I mean, beg your pardon. We come up to the third fret here, we're in C, and we just play a C octave. Okay, then move up to the fourth fret, C sharp, and then we play the sixth fret on the second string there. Okay. Then there's a sort of a little riff here. So we're on the sixth and the fourth fret. So we go, suppose. So. Okay, so just on the second and third strings there. Then we slide up to the 8th fret, play the 6th fret after that, so, there, not like that, so, slower, okay, then into the next bit of the chorus. We do a C sharp octave, and then a C low C sharp, and down to a C. So, and the same again. So, okay, and then the last bit, and this is the arguably the fiddliest bit, I would say. You make a sort of a chord shape on the fourth fret here. Same as when you played earlier on in the verse. So those three, and we play this. Okay. Okay. Then move that chord shape up. Sixth fret there, sixth and eighth frets. So, okay, so just to go through that whole chorus a bit slowly. That's it. Those are the two main sections. Get comfortable with them, put them both together, and play them along with the record once you're happy.